So the Tree Creeper, or Lizard Man as I like to call him, is my personal favorite superhero, and apparently it's Hannah Spirit's favorite as well. For those of you who don't know, she plays Abby Maitland, everyone's favorite primeval heroine. Although, personally, I'm more of a Sarah Page guy myself, but, you know, to each their own. Anyways, I call him a superhero because he actually reminds me a lot of the Lizard from the Spider-Man comics and Killer Croc from the Batman comics. You know, I guess that would actually make him more of a supervillain now that I think about it, but as a wise man once said, one man's villain is another man's hero. Also, apparently they had a crossover or two actually, and you know, now that I think about it, yeah, I would have liked to have seen the Prista Campus fight the Tree Creeper. But anyways, this isn't about Marvel or DC, this is about Primeval and specifically the Tree Creeper. So anyways, one of my favorite things about the Tree Creeper is actually its origins behind the scenes. You see, when the showrunners were designing Batman, no, not Batman, I told you, we're not talking about DC here, I mean the future Predator. One of the original designs was actually of a reptile, they call it the Future Reptile. I know, very creative. But anyways, the blurry image on the screen is this design. Unfortunately, I couldn't find a higher quality image. But you know, that's alright, I mean, after all, it's still higher quality than my videos. But anyways, of course they eventually changed the design to the one we all know and love, but they seem to have repurposed the Future Predator's original design for the Tree Creeper. And you can sort of see this in their final designs. I mean, talk about sloppy seconds. You know, both of them are bi and quadrupedal, in other words, they stand on both two and four legs, and to clarify, when I say bi, I do mean bipedal. I know, a lot of dinosaurs have horns, but this is no place for horniness, so relax. Anyways, although other creatures in the series like the Prystocampus are bi and quadrupedal as well, only the Tree Creeper and the Future Predator stand in a semi-erect position like primates do. In other words, when they stand on four legs, their backs are arched and they stand almost upright. Unlike creatures like the Prystocampus, whose back is leveled when it stands on four legs. Also, I know, I said erect. Let's laugh at the funny word. You know, while we're at it, why don't we just laugh at others like Homo erectus or Erectopus? Can we move on now? Okay, good. So anyways, although there are many other similarities between the Tree Creeper and the Future Predator, I'm not going to go through them all because ultimately, what I'm trying to convey is that the Tree Creeper looks like it could be from the future. And not only because it was originally going to be from the future, but because of how human it actually looks. Now I know. Hear me out. In 1982, paleontologist Dale Russell proposed a speculative evolution thought experiment about Styracosaurus surviving the Cretaceous Paleogene extinction event. I know, that's a lot of words, trust me, I know. Anyways, in other words, he proposed if this little guy had survived the asteroid. And to quote my nephew, big rock go boom, little guy go splat. Now, Russell speculated that if this little guy had not gone splat, it may have actually evolved into humanoid dinosaurs he called dinosauroids. And no, I am not joking about this. Trust me, this is way too good to be one of my jokes. But I do know what you're thinking. Dinosaur girlfriends. Now what did I say before? This is no place for horniness. So moving on, the reason I bring this up is because the Tree Creeper, with its sort of human-like head and arms, looks like it could be the missing link, or hypothetical missing link, between the Styracosaurus and the dinosauroid. I also bring this up because I think it's interesting how we as humans assume ourselves to be at the highest level of evolution. You know, we consider ourselves the most evolved creatures on Earth, but in reality, that's not actually true. There are plenty of creatures that are just as evolved, if not more than we are. I mean, if you measure evolution based on complexity, well, there are many creatures, let alone organisms, that are much more complex than us, and if you measure it by fitness, well, there are many organisms that are more fit than us in many environments. We just tend to think that humans are the most evolved or superior creatures on Earth because, well, we are human. It's only natural to root for the home team, and, you know, I I don't think that's a bad thing at all. I'm all for Humanity First, you know, go home team, we're number one and all that. I'm just saying that I think it's interesting how we think like this. But regardless of my pseudo-intellectual rants, Russell, being only human, assumed that Styracosaurus, I know, got for a third time. Anyways, he assumed it would have evolved into a humanoid creature, and he did receive a lot of criticism for this. Although, personally, I think that was mostly from lizardmen trying to cover up their existence, but this isn't a conspiracy theory channel. Yet. We'll see. So I'm not gonna go into it. That's all I'm trying to say. Maybe in the future. They're everywhere. Don't let them know that you know. Now, what I will get into, though, is the Tree Creeper's tail, which is a sort of fifth appendage, a lot like that of monkeys and other arboreal creatures. But what's interesting about this is that no other dinosaur had a tail like that, because no other dinosaurs were arboreal. So, if the Tree Creeper really did exist, it would have been one of, if not the most unique dinosaurs ever. And if it survived the asteroid, well, seeing how primates turned out, it may have even evolved into one of Russell's dinosauroids. Fortunately though, we primates evolved into humanoids instead of them. And we all have an asteroid we all owe it to an asteroid. Anyways, I'm starting to lose my composure here, the lizardmen are watching me. So, I'm gonna go. I actually have some tree creeping of my own to do. My crush accidentally left her window open. But before I do go, if you are interested in speculative dinosaur evolution, I've linked a few books you may want to check out. And I know, no one reads anymore, so I've also linked some videos you may also be interested in. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe if you want to see me talk about other primeval creatures. Also, don't let them know that you know. Until the next video, I'm Augustus Blake. Stay human.